Chapter 22, Clashes and Complaints. Larry had an axe to grind with his former employer for not receiving all of his vacation pay. Have an axe to grind.
Have an axe to grind. To have a selfish aim or personal motive for complaining or taking some action.
When Ben was caught stealing candy, his father ranted and raved at him. Rant and rave.
Rant and rave. To scream and shout in anger.
One day soon, I'll have it out with the professor for ignoring my questions. Have it out with.
Have it out with. To attempt to resolve issues by way of confrontation.
Mary had words with her boss after she was passed over for promotion. Have words with.
Have words with. To argue or quarrel with.
Jerry caused quite a stir when he didn't call his parents and tell them that he would be late. Everyone was really worried. Cause a stir.
Cause a stir. To create concern or worry. To cause trouble.
I don't talk to Mary anymore because she always stirs up a hornet's nest by arguing about sensitive issues. Stir up a hornet's nest.
Stir up a hornet's nest. To cause trouble. To arouse or provoke someone's anger.
Arguing with her is a waste of time. All she does is nitpick. Nitpick.
Nitpick. To make trivial distinctions when arguing or criticizing. To quibble.
Why does Mom always have to make such a big deal of my grades? Make a big deal of.
Make a big deal of. To exaggerate the significance of.
If you harp on me about work, I'll just resent you and not get it done. Harp on.
Harp on. To nag, pester, or hassle someone. To persistently ask someone to do something.
The young district attorney made a name for himself by blowing the whistle on corruption in the government. Blow the whistle.
Blow the whistle. To inform on someone for doing something wrong.
The couple's difference of philosophy in raising their children became a bone of contention in their relationship. A bone of contention.
A bone of contention. Something to fight over. A reason to quarrel.
Dominique didn't like office politics, so he would often rock the boat. Rock the boat.
Rock the boat. To disturb a smooth or stable situation by creating problems.
Web of lies. John woke up in a sweat nearly every night since he'd had words with his best friend. He'd finally had it out with Steve about his lies. He'd even said that he would blow the whistle on him if he continued. But now all John could think about was that he might end his friendship with Steve if it became a bone of contention for him. In the argument, Steve had gone on ranting and raving about John splitting hairs and harping on him about something so unimportant. "How can you make such a big deal of a few white lies?" Steve shouted. "Do you have an axe to grind with me or something?" He caused quite a stir at the restaurant. Maybe John shouldn't have rocked the boat when Steve was so sensitive, but he firmly believes that honesty is the best policy. John had no idea it would stir up such a hornet's nest. He's always complaining about his wife's nitpicking and the fact that she couldn't understand his friendship with his ex-wife. He wasn't doing anything wrong, just talking to her and hiding it from his new wife. John really didn't mean to cause such a mess, but as Sir Walter Scott put it best, "What a tangled web we weave when first we practice to deceive."